Hello class 9th, hope you all are good. Now today we will continue the same chapter, that is your periodic table, and in this video we will discuss some exercises of this chapter. Now what are transition elements? Group 3 to 12 elements are known as transition elements, and they all are matters. They lie at the center of the periodic table between highly electropositive matters on the left side and highly electronegative non-matters. Now just look at the periodic table. From 3 to 12, these elements are called what? What they are called? Transition elements. What they are called? Transition elements. And they are what? Their position is between electropositive matters, highly electropositive matters, and on left your right hand side is your this. Look at your 17 group. What these are? These are electronegative non-matters, right? Next is your what do you mean by inner transition elements? Lanthanide and actinide series are called what? Inner transition elements, means rare earth elements and radioactive elements are called inner transition elements, and they lie at the bottom of the periodic table in two horizontal rows. Lanthanide series contain in period 6 from cerium to lutetium, and actinide series, that is your in period 7 from thorium to lawrencium. Just see, look at the periodic table. This after this lanthanum, this comes what? Cerium, right? And its atomic number is 58. Means from 58 to 71, that is your lutetium, they are called what? Lanthanide series, or they are called rare earth elements. And what is the position of rare earth elements? That is your period 6, right? What they are called? Rare earth elements or lanthanide series, and their position is period 6. While your actinide series, just look at here after this actinum. After actinum, its atomic number is 89, and after that there is what? 90, thorium. Means from thorium to your lawrencium, these are the elements what? They are called what? Actinide series or radioactive elements, right? And they these inner transition elements, they all are matters and they are chemically very reactive. Next is your normal elements. Group 1 to 17. Group 1, group 2, group 13, group 14, group 15, group 16 and group 17. They are called what? Normal elements. Why they are called normal elements? Because in these elements, what's happened? The atoms of these elements have all shells complete except the outermost one. Means only outermost shell is incomplete. Rest all the shells are complete, and they consist of matters, metalloids, and non-matters. And the number of electrons in their outermost shell signify the group to which they belong. Just look at here with this periodic table. Group 1 elements, group 2 elements, then group 13 elements, group 14 elements, group 15 elements, and group 16 and group 17 elements are called what? Normal elements. Why they are called normal elements? Because they are what? All the shells are complete except the outermost shell, right? And next is your, they consist of matters, because these are all group 1 and group 2 are what? Matters. Group 13, sorry. Group 13 is also matters. Group 14, then these are what? They contain metalloids and then non-matters. The periodic table contains elements methodically grouped together. State the main helpful features of the long form of periodic table. So what are the helpful features of long form of modern periodic table? These are, first, the periodic table containing elements methodically grouped and makes a study simpler and systematic. Second, it is based upon the atomic number, which is more fundamental property of an atom, because you know that atomic number, with the help of atomic number we can find out what electronic configuration, and if we know the electronic configuration, suppose an element, atom of an element, electronic configuration is 2, 8, 1, right? So we can also know the its valency, right? Well, we know the valency electron, and then we can easily find out its valency. Its valency is what? Positive 1. So and you know that chemical properties depend on electron valency, electron, and that is your what? Electronic configuration. So we can say that because a modern periodic table is based upon atomic number, which is a more fundamental property of an atom. Now next is your, it explains variations and similarities in the properties of elements in terms of their outer electronic configuration. And fourth point is your, in this table, that is your modern periodic table, the similar elements, they are grouped together, and dissimilar elements, they have been separated, right? Name or state the following. Now, the noble gas having duplet arrangement of electron, that is your helium, because helium have atomic number is 2, so electronic configuration is 2. So it has duplet arrangement. The noble gas having an electronic configuration 288, that is your argon. A metalloid in period 2 and in period 3, that is your boron, belong to period 2. Metalloid of period 2 is boron, and metalloid of period 3 is your what? Silicon, right? Then the number of electron shells in elements of period 1. Period 1 having 1 shell, period 2 elements having 2 shells, and period 3 elements having 3 shells. Now valency of elements in group 1, that is your plus 1. Group whose elements have 0 valency, that is your group 18 elements having valency 0. An alkaline earth metal in period 3, magnesium is the alkaline earth metal of period 3. The non-metallic element present in period 3 other than sulfur and chlorine, that is your what? Phosphorus. What is it? It is your phosphorus, right? Now next is your a non-metal in period 2 having electronic configuration 2,6, that is your oxygen. An electrovalent compound formed between an alkali metal and halogen, that is your sodium chloride. Alkali sodium is a alkali metal, and halogen is your chlorine. So sodium chloride is an electrovalent compound which is formed between alkali metal and halogen. Or you can write KCl also, because here period is not mentioned. Okay, so you can write KCl also. Now a covalent compound formed between an element in period 1 and halogen, that is your hydrogen chloride or hydrochloric acid, HCl. Next is your, an alkali metal in period 3 which dissolve in water giving a strong alkali, that is your sodium. When dissolved in water, it gives what? Alkali, NaOH. Now a metal in period 3 having valency 3, that is your aluminium. Atomic number is 13, so electronic configuration is 283. Now the bridge element of period 3 of group 1, 2 and 13, that is your lithium, beryllium and boron. Lithium is what? Bridge element with magnesium. Means what are bridge elements? Actually elements of period 2, they shows resemblance with the with the properties of period 3 elements, right, of the next group. So lithium and magnesium, these are lithium properties are little bit similar to the magnesium, same way beryllium with aluminium and boron with silicon, and they are called bridge elements. Now next is your, the period which contain the inner transition element, that is your 6th period and 7th period contain inner transition elements. Right, now the formula of a hydroxide of the element having electronic configuration 282, that is your MgOH whole twice. What is it? A magnesium hydroxide, MgOH whole twice. Now the valency of element in period 3 having atomic number 17, that is your minus 1, And one metal in period 2, which is tetravalent, that is your carbon. Now look at this, fill in the blanks from words A to F given below. You have to write whether decreases, increases or remains same, or electropositive or electronegative. Now first we will talk about the across a period. Across a period from left to right means when you move from left to right in your modern periodic table, number of electron shares, what you will say? They are what? Remain same. What you will say? It will come, what will come here? Remain same. Number of valency electron increases by 1. And electronegativity, what do you say? When you are moving forward, left to right means when suppose we are talking about period 2. When we are moving from period 2 to period 2 from left to right, then electronegativity increases. And character of elements changes from, what you will say, electropositive to electronegative. What will come here? Here will E to F. Right? Now, come to down a group in a modern periodic table. Number of electron shares, what you will say, increases. Number of valency electron remain same. Electronegativity, what you will say, decreases. And character of elements changes from electronegative to electropositive. When we move down in a group, then what's happened? And suppose when we are moving down in a group, then if you will just talk to chlorine, bromine, they are what, most electronegative. But when we move down, this electronegativity decreases. So what you say? Characters of elements changes from electronegative to electropositive, right?